Welcome to your franchise staff. That's just how I'm feeling. Staff points can be used when you have to see some talent trees make you select a path. I'm out here trying to make a killer, stack a couple million to the ceiling. When I touch down, I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's just how I'm feeling. That's just how I'm feeling.
Normal feel.
Dog, that's just how I'm feeling.
Hey, Belly, them ready?
When I touch down, I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's
them gyal a red eye, never make right. Me they a suffer life, them a get by. Never bow for the fame, heads high. The back of me so all them a see a tear light. Been a real from the ghetto. I ain't never gon' switch, that's facts though. Can't get me out like stain. Come a grow tough, I'ma know pain. Haters talk with a bad tongue. Can't break me, twiddle so dumb. I'ma be a giant thief, I hope I'm doing it so big like Drake, I'm on one. My big box got me feeling so bossy like Lauren Hill, me I kill them softly. This a girl rather fi be called a naughty, cause if my two liar, then it's gon' cost me. And
that's just how I feel.
Yeah.
That's just how I'm feeling.
That's how I feel.
Dog, that's just how I'm feeling. When I touch down, I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's just how I'm feeling. Big boss, I'm a big boss. Up north, Rick Ross. I got the pump that'll make you jump. Don't you ever get it crisscross. Don't you ever get it crisscross. Don't you ever get it crisscross. I got the pump that'll make you jump. Don't you ever get it crisscross. Bet against me, that's a big love. You about to find out what the call. I find then I get low. Lift up, it ain't nothing to cut the up. Stop frying, don't let it get soft. Covered in yolk, in yolk. Wonder why I got the whole world pissed off. That's just how I'm feeling. Dog, that's just how I'm feeling. When I touch down, I'ma burn it all.
Today, from Gillette Stadium in Foxborough, it's week 7 of the NFL on EA Sports.
Getting toward the halfway point of the NFL season, week 7 is underway on EA Sports. And the opening kickoff will not be returned, as that will be a touchback. So now here comes the Jet offense as they get ready to take over. They'll be led by the second-year man from the University of Alabama, Tua Tagovailoa.
And coming off of an early season open week, and in this situation, what he told us when we sat down with him was he spent a lot of time working on fundamentals, kind of getting back to basics during that time, as opposed to having to worry about healing up or resting up. It's too early in the season. Get back to the basics, get his game going again.
Give him three there on the first play of the game, and it's second down. Now Sanders fighting through, and he's taken down but able to slip across the 35.
Usually we see runs like this as the defense breaks down later in the game, but this guy is setting the tone early, running through all types of tackles and putting the defense back on its heels.
On first and 10, it's Sanders. And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41. Well, these two teams, you might remember, met in Foxborough earlier in the season with the Patriots winning that ball game. So they're trying to win here in Foxborough to capture the season series. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. Throwing is Tagovailoa on third down here. And this is going to be incomplete. So the defense able to get off the field here on third down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on third down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
The 41-yard punt, 9 on the return. And the Patriots take over. So out comes this offense to take over for the first time. They will be led out by their now 44-year-old quarterback playing in his 22nd NFL season. Unbelievable. The great Tom Brady. Brady now on first down. And he's going to drop this down to McCaffrey. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds.
Nice little nifty play for him there. Yeah, that's the ability to read a defense and utilize players that don't often get picked up in coverage easily. And I'm talking about being able to use the backside of the backfield. Because I know that when I used to cover, hey, we got everybody oh, he just snuck out there, and they just got a nice first down there.
What do we love to say? Get those backs into space, right? They were able to do that there. Nice pickup on first down. And it's incomplete, broken up. But there is a flag down. Let's see what that's about. Well, as a lineman, they are trained. You've got to stay close to home. If you're more than a yard downfield, they're going to toss that flag, and they did there. Second down and right back to McCaffrey. And he stopped immediately there. And some secondary help here for the defense in the nickel on third and long. Play action. Now it's Brady. Now a leaping catch. He's got it. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. On play action. Now Brady. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. Here's second and 10. First carry for Damian Harris, the Alabama man. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a third and 8 coming up. And they run with Harris off the option. And he can only get this to the 42-yard line. And that is not near enough. Give him a couple on the run as it brings up the fourth down. Brady to throw for it on fourth down. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Kyle Ford. And the Jets force the turnover. They'll take over at their own 27. Jet sweep to start the drive. And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. 8 yards to go on second down. Tua gonna throw. He'll get this into the hands of Van Jefferson. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. They'll run on first down. It's Sanders, and he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. No score after one on EA Sports. Here's Sanders. Gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. 45 yards rushing for him now on just 6 carries to this point. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Shotgun snap and then the give to Sanders. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Deshaun Elliott up to make the play defensively. It's a second down run with Sanders. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11.
Count me as a little bit surprised by what we just saw there, because this has been a pretty long drive. And normally you think that wears down a defense. In this case, looked like the offensive line let him down a little bit.
Yeah, allowed the penetration and the ability to stuff him for a loss. Out of bounds inside the 30. 5 yards, not enough, and it'll be fourth down.
The key to any screen play is all in the deception. That means everyone on the offensive side of the ball, but someone gave it up because that one wasn't very well concealed, and the defense able to rally to him and hold him for just a short gain.
Now the Jets will call on a field goal unit here. Spotted at the left hash, this from 45. The kick by Carlson is good. And the Jets hit the board first. It's 3-0. So he's been automatic to this point of the season, and he connects on the field goal there.
And what a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon, partner, because he hasn't missed all year long. Converts on that one as well. And kudos to you. You didn't jinx it.
And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. The Pats at the line, ready to go. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, only gave up 3 points off of that, so it shouldn't be a difficult hole to overcome.
It really shouldn't, as long as they're not listening to the chatter coming from the other side, because when you throw a pick, look, I know defensive backs, they have a tendency to be a little bit loud after they take one away, but they also have a tendency to gamble a little bit more, thinking they'll get a second one. Maybe they can take advantage of that with some double moves.
They come up now, 3rd and 5, following the incomplete pass. Brady gonna throw. Being chased out left. Throw outside, McCaffrey's got it. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. So in Jet territory now. Here's 1st and 10 at the 48-yard line. Eluding the pressure right. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. An incomplete pass on 1st down. That leads to a 2nd and 10. Brady to throw again. He's going to look deep for Watkins. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be 3rd down. Throwing is Brady on 3rd down. The catch is made here by Tyler Lockett. His 4th touchdown on the year. And the Patriots have taken the lead. Brady will look to throw for it. That's caught at the 1. And he is into the end zone to bump the lead up 2 more. He hits the big target for the 2-point try. Defenses hate those guys, especially around the goal line.
It's hard to decide who you're going to put on him. Are you going to put a smaller corner on him? Are you going to put a safety who doesn't have maybe the same coverage skills? How about a linebacker? He may have the size, but he's not used to really covering in space. That's why the tight end gives you such a great advantage when you're throwing the football.
A look at the running back, the man out of the backfield as he gears up to go again. He's been good. They've utilized him well, but they're losing here in the 2nd quarter. What might they change offensively?
I think that what you try and do is expand how you get the ball to him a little bit. Get him out in open space, maybe swing the ball to him. What's that they used to call it in the West Coast offense, the long handoff? Yeah. Serve as your running play that way, as well as continue to feed him the football. Some of these runs now may pop bigger later in the game because of the effects of running it. Sometimes people, after a while, they don't want to tackle him anymore. Or they get tired and they get out of position, or he runs through tackles. Continue to feed him the ball. He's having that kind of game.
Yeah, might they get him the ball in some space in some different ways here? A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
best multitasker in the business, the coach.
Here's the Jets punter now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. 44 on his first punt, and this is a good kick as well. It's a 43-yard punt, a return of 5, and the offense will take over with a new set of downs. New England with a first down as they begin the drive. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Well, he was just trying to contain DeAndre Hopkins, and he got a little too close.
And because of his ability to line up in different spots on the field and come at you from different angles, different guys have to cover him, and all of them have the same issue. How do you do it without interfering? In this case, it didn't get done.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Now Brady. And it's incomplete. Boy, the numbers throwing the football just not trending in the right direction. Last week he was under 50%. He's under 50% again here.
And we haven't gotten an announcement, but it appears to me that he might be a little dinged up and is just trying to play through. You know, he's one of those tough guys that wants to answer the bell each and every play for his team. That might be throwing off his accuracy.
The three straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on fourth. From the gun, it's Brady. He'll lock it with a grab over the middle. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. They come up here with another shot from the 6-yard line, and it's second and goal now. Brady now to throw. Sliding out of the pocket. And this is going to be intercepted. Shaquille Griffin with a pick. And the Jets are going to take possession here at their own 3-yard line. It'll be Sanders to begin the drive. And he'll work this forward for about 3 at second down. Second and 7. Now as we look down, it appears we've got a Jet shaking up on the play. We'll get a report when we return to Foxborough. Throw's going to be incomplete.
They've been playing sound fundamental defense thus far and able to keep this offense from creating a major dent on the scoreboard.
Able to force the incompletion, but still waiting for that game-changing play. You feel like it's coming, the first sack, the first turnover.
In a sense, they're playing old-school defense right now. The new-school defense is what you said, taking the ball away.
Here's the Jets punter now, as he'll come on to kick this one away. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Able to slither by. That'll go as a 46-yard punt with a return of 7. And the Patriots will have great starting position as they take over first and 10. The Patriots with the football here late in this first half. They'll be taken down. The Jets get in there for the sack. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. To try again after the sack. Brady, and seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm, incomplete. Now it's third down. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. They'll set up the screen to McCaffrey. And they will advance this across midfield, but still well shy of a first as he's tackled at the 47. And this offense going to elect to burn a timeout with 5 seconds remaining in quarter number 2. It's running out of steam, and it won't get there. He left it just short. No good. The second half upon us sooner than we bargained for. Week 7, second half. Let's do it. The question to be asked, where does this game go from here? And he can't field it cleanly. It's loose on the return. And he won't get this to the 20-yard line as he's down at the 19. Right. The Pats at the line, ready to go. And Charles, they've got the lead. I would imagine the overall halftime tone was a positive one, but what do you think the talking points were in the locker room?
Well, if there were three talking points at the half, partner, all of them were about turnovers because they were pretty loose with the ball. Otherwise, this lead could be even bigger. Now, I don't think that they overly harped on it, but I think they told them, guys, if you want to keep calling those plays that are exciting, you got to take care of the ball. Otherwise, we may have to dial things back a little bit. And a nice call and really good execution there because they gave him a little bit of a different launch angle, perhaps, you know. You don't want to have the quarterback dropping back 5 to 7 steps on every play and have the defense zero in on him. There you hope that you get your defense going one way. They sent him the other, and they picked up nice yardage with that completion.
Looking to throw again on second down. Brady. And a high throw there as this is knocked away, down to the ground and incomplete.
There is something to a game plan with trying to keep a defense honest. With a guy with that type of speed, you do so. Send him deep, try to throw some air under it, and hope you connect downfield. On that play, they were unsuccessful.
And that's caught inside the 35. Now he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. A big play there for the Patriots. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. This is McCaffrey on the give. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down. They're going to hurry back to the line now. On play action, it's Brady. He'll buy some time right. Looking sideline, incomplete.
As soon as I saw him break contain and get outside, my first thought and my eyes gravitated downfield because nowadays, most of these quarterbacks, when they do that, they want the big play downfield. They don't want to throw it short. In this case, he took the shot. It fell incomplete.
And he will have a Patriots first down. They needed 5 there on third down. He winds up getting 7. This is Harris. Oh, what a move. Pushing his way through. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. His 3rd rushing touchdown of the year, his 5th overall. And the Patriots take the opening kickoff of the 3rd quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
I don't know about you, but I can't wait for a few years of 2-point tries and see what the data tells us, because a lot of teams want to throw the ball in this situation, this time unsuccessfully. I just wonder if maybe running the ball might be the way to go.
With it moved up from the 3 to the 2, you would think maybe a few more attempts at running.
I think stats over time may bear out that running the ball will at least be the equal of throwing it in that situation.
They start on the ground here at Sanders. And he'll wind up with about 6, up past the 30 to the 31. They'll come up now 2nd and 4 from the 31. Another run with Sanders. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. 62 yards rushing on 12 carries for him now. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on 1st and 10. Throwing now is Tagovailoa. They'll roll him out right, and he'll take this beyond the line of scrimmage as he slides to a halt. 2nd down and 7. Tua sets up to pass it. And it's hauled in by Jared Cook. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. First down, Sanders. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. 2nd and 11 now. Back-to-back stops make it 3rd and 10. Those are the plays this defense needs with the deficit they're facing.
It certainly is, and they've got to continue to swarm the football and hope that someone, while they're holding up the ball carrier, can get in there and rake it and lock it free. They need to get some takeaways as well.
And he can only manage to get this to the 45-yard line. Well short of the first. Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to fourth down. On fourth down, the punt team is on as this is sent away. Returnable for Lockett. Call that a punt of 38 yards officially. And the Pats will be backed up deep to get the drive started as they take over first and 10. New England with a first down as they begin the drive. Last time they were out here, they had the benefit of good field position, led to a touchdown. This time, they're going to have to work for it.
They are, but with that last drive that culminated in a touchdown, I think they carry that confidence into this one. It doesn't matter where you start with the football now, they have to feel great about their opportunity.
Now a give, right side McCaffrey. And they're able to bring him down at the 20. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Brady now on first down. He'll get this underneath to McCaffrey. And he's going to get 7 out of this before being taken down at the 27. They're down here in the fourth, and that personal foul penalty is not going to help.
No, in these types of situations, players will tell you that's extra intensity. From where we sit, it's actually frustration, not a good play.
On the give, this is Harris. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. They run with Harris. And he's got some space here. And down to the 20 he'll go before heading out of bounds.
I think we're seeing the effect that runs like that are starting to have on this game. They're a little bit slower, that front seven, reacting to the football, almost like body blows in boxing. Slowing them down, and they're really starting to take over in this game.
Kaywan Williams, the one that got him down. Well, no doubt here in the fourth quarter, this is a huge defensive series.
Hey, they can read the scoreboard. They realize if they give up a field goal here, this game might be out of reach. They understand the stakes and are playing accordingly.
Now they'll throw with Brady. Flushed out right. And that'll fall incomplete. He was hit just as he let that go. And now it's third down. New England on third down. They've had good success, 5 for 8 to this point. This will be 3rd and 6. And he is going to be stopped at the 12, short of the first down. The offense going to stay out there. They've converted once, failed once. What can they do here on fourth down? And he's in. Touchdown, Patriots. Damian Harris, his 2nd touchdown of the afternoon. And the Patriots are looking to make it 2 straight as they add on to this fourth quarter lead. McCaffrey will try to run it in. So a big decision there to go on fourth down. Gets him not only the first, but gets him the touchdown as well.
And Brandon, you and I know that all these coaches tell us if every play is executed the way it's designed, it goes for a touchdown. But let's be honest, they were shooting for the first down on that one. And boy, were they fortunate to take it all the way in.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. Well, I think that the folks here had hoped that maybe this home atmosphere would carry their guys to a surprise victory, but it does not appear that that's going to be the case. There's too much to handle on the other side in this one. 2nd and 6. From the gun, it's Tua. And one more time, here's Kirk. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. On first down, Tagovailoa throwing the out route, incomplete. It's Cook. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, 2nd and 2. Tua to throw again. Tua hit, and the ball is out.
Much like a running back going through the line, quarterbacks have to be aware of protecting the football as well. He left it exposed that time. Wound up having it knocked free, but fortunately, had an alert teammate who was able to get it.
And Sanders has it poked free, and it's picked up by the Patriots.
Great shot.
He's into the end zone. It's a fumble return and a pick. Patriot touchdown. So now Brady and the Patriots going for two. Now after the fumble recovery, it's Brady. And this is going to be caught. So add two more to the lead as they continue to pour it on here in the fourth.
Personally, I'd rather see him kick the extra point there than to go for two, but it almost feels like there's a story within the story here. I mean, this isn't college. You know, size of victory, that matters in those games. Here, all you have to do is win by 1 point. That's all that you need. Instead, they go for it, get two. You got some pretty ticked off folks on the other sideline now.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. That's complete to his running back, Jefferson. And we are inside of 2 minutes left in this lopsided affair. So it's Jets football as we get you reset here. A good gain on first has him set up with second and just a couple of inches now from the 29. Tagovailoa working out of the gun. Oh, he tries to force it in and it's intercepted. Picked off by the Pro Bowler, Marcus Peters. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Patriot defense has a touchdown. So this defense doubling its pleasure there. Remember, they had the fumble return for a score earlier in the game. And now this time, an interception return for another score. So after the INT, it's Brady. Escaping the pressure right. And he will get into the end zone, but there is a flag down. This one may be coming back. Umpire threw the flag, usually always indicates holding, and that's what we've got.
And you know, depending on their positioning, where you are on the field, the umpires get different responsibilities, but always, always making sure no one's holding.
That's caught. And they're just not going to let up as he is into the end zone here for two more.
I think this is just going to be a function of the times we live in now. Very similar to the bat flip in baseball. Everyone's got to start to get comfortable with this. But to me, this is just rubbing it in. You got a big lead. Go ahead and take the extra point. One thing to keep in mind, though, karma's still out there. And sometimes it has a way of catching up with you.
New York ready to go again offensively. We certainly had a sense coming in here that these guys were in for a tough one on the road. That has been how this ball game has played out. They trail big as we continue on now here in this fourth quarter. Tagovailoa trying again after the pick six. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of seven past the 30 to the 32. 3 yards remain for second down. Going to the air, Tagovailoa. Middle of the field to Jefferson. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. Here's Tagovailoa on first and 10. The Pats are going to get there. Down he goes. They overload him that time with a safety blitz, and he winds up being dropped for a loss of seven. Now following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. Tua's throw into the hands of Kirk. And he'll be out of bounds up near the 45 at the 44. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. Here's Tagovailoa to throw. And that is incomplete.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. Now it's Lockett. Call that a 41-yard punt, 6 yards on the return. And control of the football switching hands here with very little time remaining in this contest. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. The drive begins with a run by McCaffrey. And he'll be taken down at the 20 after a gain of just one. Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Brady going to throw here. Going deep for Hopkins. And that going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down. Fourth quarter, you've got the big lead. If you're coaching, Charles, you still taking shots like that downfield?
I'd be a little more concerned with running some clock and making sure you're taking care of the lead, because you keep flinging it around, you throw a couple of picks, you can put yourself in jeopardy.
And he'll be stopped here well short of the first down at the 24-yard line. And now we're going to get a timeout. Somewhat pointlessly called with 3 seconds to go in a game that's already been decided. And with things looking pretty good on the scoreboard, they're going to keep the offense out there and go for it here on fourth. They run for it with Harris, and he won't get there. They stop him a few yards short of the line. On third down, here's Jones. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. Defense had a chance to get off the field here on the opening drive, couldn't do it.
I know that we go into these meetings with coaches, and sometimes maybe we can get, you know, a little bit numb because they're always going to talk about
the Panther rush too strong. They get there and take him down. Von Miller in there to drop him for his 11th sack of the year. Another try after the first down sack. Love. He'll find Smith-Schuster. That's complete.
And that was yardage that they needed there after the sack on first down. They didn't get all of it back, but now they look at third down as a manageable situation, one that they have a much better chance of picking up.
And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. They go back to the ground with Jones. And just shedding him off there. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. That's his longest run of the first quarter. And, Charles, we talked before the game about them needing to establish the run game. They'll be looking for more of that.
And they got to the perimeter. So that tells me that that's part of the game plan of what they want to get done today. So they'll have some complimentary runs where he'll run it to the inside. But it appears that when they want the big yardage, they think they can get to the outside and make it happen.
That one whistled against a big right tackle.
You'd think being able to fire out and block would be a lot easier to not commit a holding penalty, but it's tough to keep those guys right in front, isn't it?
2 yards on the pickup. It'll be second down. Defensively, they had that one pretty well figured out.
Yeah, one of the things about this play, it can be even more effective when you run a lot of motion and there's plenty of times you don't hand it off.
And he will reach the 8-yard line before going out. The 13th play now coming on this opening drive. Here's third down. To pass, here's Jordan Love. And that is caught. He's got it for a giant touchdown. Randall Cobb, his 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Giants take it right down and score on the opening drive. Gold able to tack on the extra point. And that makes the score 7-0. After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gold now to kick it away. Jamal Agnew now to return it. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. Offensively for Carolina, Teddy Bridgewater will be at the controls, the talented quarterback out of Louisville.
And what a first half of the season he's had, leading the NFL in passing yards to this point. He's been a tough man to slow down. So this defense certainly has its work cut out for him.
Bridgewater going to lead the Panthers up here, first and 10 at their own 22. Run there on first down as Henry uses his size to plow forward, call it a pickup of 7. Henry again on second down. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. A solid run by Derrick Henry, and here's another first and 10. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Joey Bosa, he's the one that got home and takes him down for a loss of 9. After the sack, it's 2nd and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. Bridgewater's throw taken in there by Cooks. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Bridgewater now looking to throw on first. Flush to his right. And he will find the rookie from Purdue. That's Rondale Moore. 7 yards, the pickup there. To throw again on second down. Bridgewater eluding the pressure right. It's just a gain of a couple there on the scramble, and now it's third down.
Yeah, not much there that time, and I think we were both wondering once he got out of the box whether he just throw the ball away and he winds up only picking up a yard or two.
They'll try to run for the first with Henry. And he gets it to the 34. Good enough for the first. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Derrick Henry working his way for a gain of 7 to the 26. So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. A first down carry for Henry. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. They'll try to throw here now. Bridgewater. Now he's hit, and Bridgewater loses the football. And who's got it? The Giants! Holding on to the football, becoming a little bit of an issue. He had 2 fumbles last week, remember.
I played for a guy that used to talk all the time about creating turbulence in the pocket, making the quarterback jumpy, make him antsy, keep getting after him a little bit, and make sure he thinks about holding on to the ball because you're going after him.
Throwing again on 2nd down. Love. Room to run past midfield and all the way down to the 41-yard line.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing, but as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15,
pressure comes in. He's brought down. It's a Panther sack. Chris Barnes in there to drop him for a loss on the play. Love, they go play action now. And that went a little too high as it's knocked away and incomplete. The Giants on 3rd down. A perfect 3 for 3 as they look to keep that streak going. This is 3rd and 10. He'll drop this underneath for Jones. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. 1:58 left to play till we hit halftime. And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. They'll find Ayuk open right side. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Ahead of the chains now, 2nd and 2. Now Love. Throw that side complete to Smith-Schuster. And the Giants are going to be set up with a 1st and goal coming up as they get him down at the 6-yard line. Again, it's Love. And he's got it. Touchdown, Giants. Aaron Jones, his 11th touchdown of the year. And the Giants are able to grow their lead. Gold with the extra point, and it's now 14-0. So that drive goes 8 plays, and it was finished off by a touchdown by the New York Giants. To return, here's Agnew. And he'll be stopped up at the 25. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And last time, the turnover on the fumble, and they were in enemy territory, so that had to be very frustrating. Down on the scoreboard here, can't do it again.
You nailed every part of what was frustrating. Down on the scoreboard, had a drive going, and pushed it past the 50-yard line, so they felt like they were in striking distance, and to come away with nothing, not a good feeling at all, to put it mildly. Now they can't afford to do that again.
Yeah, now can they get that bat? And that is caught one-handed. Oh, my, pulled it in. A big play that time through the air. 39 yards. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for 1st and 10. And opening there on that first down run as he gets this forward for about 8 or 9. That looks to be 8 officially, so 2nd and 2. Rolling to his right. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked up by the Michigan man, Jabril Peppers. And the Giantsons are going to take over at their own 28-yard line. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And with a 2-score lead already, they may just look to get this thing to the locker room. The Loves throw into the hands of Cobb. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. The Giants going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 27 seconds remaining here in the 2nd quarter. First down, love to pass. That's going to go as a loss of a full 8 yards. And it sets him back for second down. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as they stop it with 19 seconds to go in half number one. Throwing on second and long. Love. And they can't bring him down. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. Now the Giants will use the second of their three timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. Third and two. Love with it. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Stephon Gilmore. And a potential turning point as he'll get the football in very good field position late in this first half. But when I looked down, he was kind of shaking his head right after he threw that pass. What did you see?
Well, from a defense's perspective, anytime you have your eyes back towards the quarterback, you're in a position to make a play on the ball, whether it's a big-time play by you or an overthrow by the quarterback. You have a much better opportunity.
The long-distance shot before break comes up empty, but now Charles flipped the script. Time for likely one more play as field position becomes an issue.
Yeah, when you talk about field position, remember, if this kick is missed, the ball comes back to where? The spot that they snapped it from. So field position becomes a factor. I think in this spot, you might also want to think about throwing the Hail Mary. You know, put the ball up in the air, maybe you can get six.
The second half upon us sooner than we bargained for. Week 7, second half, let's do it. The Panthers going to get the football first, trailing here as well as we resume play in this second half. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much as he's marked down officially at the 21. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. To this point, the results have not been good. 2 possessions, 2 turnovers.
And that's obviously something that can't continue, but to go a little bit deeper on that one, I would think about some play calls now, not even necessarily to my best play, but to someone I can trust with the ball, try and get things settled down a little bit.
So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. Only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
And he'll get this one up to about his 14. And the offense moving quickly to the line. Second down, they go again with Henry. And a nice gain there as he'll be taken down just shy of the 20. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Sliding out of the pocket. And that will be incomplete.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable. And that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
And he'll be corralled well upfield right around the 40-yard line. And quickly, they get to the line. A first down throw for Bridgewater. That's caught. He finds Amendola again. And they get to him after a gain of 6 to the 46. Looking to throw again on second down. Bridgewater. And he's got Amendola on the connection. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. He'll fire it deep for Rager. Oh, you saw that one coming. It's intercepted. Thrown back across his body. Picked up by the Michigan man, Jabril Peppers. And the Giants are going to get the football here as he gets this up to the 38-yard line. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And their defense just helped him out by getting the football back on the opening drive here the second half. And now can the offense follow through with points on their first possession?
And that's a big one for them because after the work the defense has done, they've got a chance here to open up this lead.
Out of the shotgun, it's Love. This one swung out here to Jones. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. 5 yards. Now it's 3rd and 5. Working out of the gun. Love. And this pass broken up. And the contact well timed there. And now fourth down. And the Giants send out their punter now. And the way this offense has moved the ball, he hasn't been needed till here in the third. And a nice special teams job here. This is going to be down inside the 10 at the 7-yard line. And for an offense that is struggling, this is not where you want to start from. Great punt.
Fantastic punt. And for all those who wonder, what do punters do during the course of practice each and every day? The best ones do what we just saw there. Work on positioning the football and helping their team.
And now they're in the hurry up. Henry again on second down. And he'll get it up here this time to the 21. Now after the running play, we've got a man down on the field. We'll get an update when we return to MetLife Stadium. They'll run on first down. Henry, and he'll take it ahead to the 28-yard line. A good run, got seven on first. Here's second and three. Henry running right. And this is going to be a Panthers first down as he's able to get this up to the 37-yard line. Out of the gun, Bridgewater. This is Smith with a grab. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. Now that's one they hate. The ball's got to come all the way back.
So that's an explosive play, a really explosive play that gets wiped out, and they have to start over after the penalty.
And the giant rush gets home as down he goes. So Bridgewater needing to work a little magic after that sack on a third and long. He's letting it fly for Cooks, and that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down. This offense converted once on fourth down earlier. Now they're out there again to try once more. He's going to air it out deep for Amendola. Oh, and Bridgewater intercepted for the third time. Picked up by Charvarius Ward. And he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line. First and 10, and kind of tipping their hand at running the ball. Three tight ends are out there. The give is to Jones. Broken tackle. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. They'll go again to Jones. And he's going to get this inside the 30. 51 yards now on the ground on just seven carries.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
2 yards the loss, second and 12. We have played three quarters. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Switching things up, they'll throw it now with Jordan Love. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game. The Giants on third down. They've converted four times out of six. Not bad. This time it's third and three. They'll try and run for it with Jones. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. And a loss of three to bring up four. The kick by Gold is good. And the lead will grow. It's now 17-0. So that almost certainly the final piece to this puzzle, a three-score lead. I don't think there's any coming back from there.
But you know, normally I'd get on you for giving up on the game right here, but I do think you're right in this case. This late in the game, two scores is tough enough. Three, I'm with you. That seems out of the question.
And out a little across the 25 to the 27. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And let's face it, this drive is not going to have any bearing on this game, but it's kind of important for one reason, isn't it?
It certainly is. You got to get points. And okay, all right, I'm being facetious here. But you get points, you feel a little bit better about yourself as you move on to the next one.
On second and 10, Bridgewater to the right side, and he's got more complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. On first and 10, Bridgewater. And this one is incomplete. Second and 10. Throwing, Bridgewater. Amendola has it. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Giants' 41-yard line. From the shotgun, it's Bridgewater. Flushed out right. Bears it out toward the corner of the end zone. And incomplete on the deep ball.
We've seen that the deep ball's been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down. The Panthers on third down. Just 1 for 3 thus far. This is third and 10. And again, it's Bridgewater. He'll drop this one down to Cohen. And they'll get him down at the 34. And he's going to be short of the first by a few yards. So they'll get 8 out of that completion. And that'll bring up fourth down. Matt Rhule, a risk taker in college, going for it. They'll run for it with Henry. And he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. Henry. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5. And they're going to speed things up here. Henry will get it. He's been busy today. And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run. Got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
So through 3 quarters, no reason to lighten up now. Oh, this one incomplete. The pressure got to him as he released it. And it's second down. And he'll be hit as he releases it. And that'll fall incomplete. This offense was on the move. Now 2 straight incompletions have them looking at 3rd and 10. From the gun, Bridgewater. And they work this near the 5. He'll be stopped at the 6. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. They've got it 1st and goal as they look to punch in a late score. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop him right around the 1. 2nd and goal from the 1. Now a look at Smith. Not sure exactly what happened, but he's still down. We'll get an update when we return to MetLife Stadium. This likely a must-have. 3rd and goal. Trying to punch it in with Henry. And Henry fighting for the marker, but I don't think he got there. He did not. The field goal doesn't help. They're going to go for the 6 here on, and he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. Derrick Henry, his first touchdown on the year. And the Panthers are finally on the board here in the 4th quarter. Bridgewater will try and throw. And the Panthers are going to have 1st and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. So 2 scores down, time definitely not an ally, but here comes the onside kick. And this is going to be covered up by the Giants. They knew they needed a miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Well, as we knew, even before they put the toe to the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. I think we're down to 9. The Panthers going to use the 2nd of their timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming 2nd down play. Again, it's Jones. 1st down and much more here for Jones. And he'll finally be taken down at the 2-yard line. 87 yards rushing for him so far as his terrific season continues here. Well, they probably don't need to run a play here, but you wonder if they're going to be able to resist on first and goal. And the Giants will kneel it here out of the victory formation. So they're backed up to the 3-yard line, second and goal. So a victory here for the men in blue, the New York Giants. And I think the game balls need to be distributed on the defensive side of the football, and I bet that you would agree.
Yeah, if you hold a team under 10 points, that's a job well done, really well done. So I would say game balls for every starter and every key player who participated in this game.
Now, see, I only like one game ball. You're handing out multiple, although I set you up by saying game balls, plural. Yeah,
But I like where we're going with this, though. You say one to represent, like, the best player of all of that. And I say multiples so that you keep everyone motivated and involved.
You're a man of the people.
I'm a man of the people.
Check, you was on for a minute.